and some of you may or may not have heard of it. But I love the simplicity of this song because in the chorus, most of it just says Jesus. And you know, I was thinking about that this morning as I was getting ready for church, and I was thinking, man, how simple it is and how powerful it is to know that we have the authority just by the name of Jesus. Amen. There's no other God out there that gives you that kind of authority and that kind of strength just in a name. And so this morning, as we sing this song, I just want you to think about that, because the Bible teaches us and it shows us time and time and time again that there is nothing that we cannot overcome and nothing that we cannot conquer in the name of Jesus. So this morning, as we sing that, I want you to think about those things that are troubling us, those things that are holding us back, and remember that Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the way that we get through those things, because he gives us the authority to conquer over those things that are holding us back. So this morning, let's just worship God this morning. Amen.
Thank you. sing how beautiful
beautiful name it is, the name of
You know, many times we can go to places and things that really has no meaning. We can shout, we can cheer on, we can have a good time. But isn't it better that you know that when you call upon the name of the Lord, that He's there? Isn't it better to know that whenever you call upon Him, you say, Father, I have a need, He's there. You can cheer that football team on, you can cheer the basketball team on, you can cheer all these other things on, but I'm telling you right now, as much as you cheer for them, there may not, something may never happen, but whenever you call on the name of the Lord, something happens. The Word teaches us that He will move mountains to get to us. I know for myself that I know where I have been, and I know where God has brought me from, and I know He heard my cry. What a powerful, what a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. The Word teaches us that we have not because we ask not. Sometimes we feel like that we're not good enough. Come on now. Sometimes we feel like we've done too much. Sometimes we feel like that we're not in the place that we need to be. But the Word says He wants us just as we are. Come just as you are. You were created by Him, for Him. The enemy teaches us and tells us and tries to persuade us that our guilt and our shame is the best we'll ever be. But God says He will create in us a new heart, a newness about us. This morning, why don't we let God be God? Amen. As they sing this just one more time, I just want you to realize that the enemy wants you to stay where you're at. Don't let him win today. Don't give him more power than God, because I'm telling you, that's what we do. We give more power, more authority to our circumstances and our faults and our failures than we do God Himself, that says, behold, I create a new thing. Every day, every time, every instance, God creates something new and wonderful. What a powerful, wonderful name of Jesus. He says that His name alone, you speak to the enemy, he's got to go. You speak to the mountains, it has to move. That's the power and authority that God gives us.
Christ, my King.
realize you're there, Father. We know that you're there. So God, right now, I pray, Lord, that you open every ear and every heart this morning, God. Father, that we not only hear your word, but Father, we receive it as well, God. And Father, once again, Lord, I ask you to anoint these old clay lips, Father God, as you continue to hide me behind that cross of Calvary. And God, we give you the glory and the honor in Jesus' name. And amen.
Amen.
Amen. Go ahead and give God.